started my night with, or my flight, shall we say, with a gin and tonic to cool down. Now that I've cooled down somewhat, I feel a lot better. And I had a delightful little Bushmills 10-year-old single malt as my first whiskey of the flight. Now I've got to cleanse my palate. And not too long ago, Aquavite sent me a package with different whiskeys, samples. There were 5 samples, and it was a blind taste test kit, basically. And in that kit, there were a couple of bars of dark chocolate and something else that I had never tried before, but was quite delighted to enjoy. And it was a kind of a palate cleanser that goes in between drums and just takes all of the flavor away from your mouth that was there before. And it's this. These are oat cakes. You may notice that it says Orkney oat cakes on the top, and then it says Galette d'Avoine Orkney. This is, I guess, intended for the Canadian market. I bought it at Walmart, and if not for Aquavite sending me a package of these little oat cakes, I would never have known about them, and I would never have looked. Well, I found them at Walmart in the British imported food section. These are great. Great for cleansing the palate, especially especially when you're going from one type of whiskey to another that's completely has a different taste profile. This will even get rid of flavors of peated whiskey. So I had an Irish 10-year-old single malt. Now I have a bourbon. Some would call it Bulleit, and it's got a 10-year-old age statement. Others would call it, depending on what European country you're in, it would be Bulleit or Bulleit. If you have a bit of a German-speaking heritage like I do, it would be Bulleit. In French, I think they would pronounce it Bulleit. Anyway, in the USA, I believe they mostly pronounce it Bulleit. Depends where you're from, I suppose. The man who started this brand, Augustus Bulleit or Bulleit, he was from northern France, I believe, Alsace-Lorraine or somewhere like that. But the name is probably, could even be Flemish or from Belgium or Holland or somewhere like that. Maybe Germany, I'm not sure. Somewhere in Europe. The name may have changed too. They changed the spelling. Who knows? But the story goes that he was on his way to St. Louis or somewhere to sell his whiskey. And he disappeared, just poof, disappeared into thin air. They never found him. They found his cart or his wagon, whatever, containing the barrels of whiskey, but they never found him. I think that's what the story was. I forget where I read it. It's kind of a legend almost. Could have been on their website. Anyway, it doesn't say much here except Kentucky Straight Bourbon Whiskey, aged 10 years, Frontier Whiskey. And there's some. Small batch, okay. 45.6% alcohol by volume. Now let's figure out if this is monkey proof. It looks like there's a plastic thing. Ah, I believe I may have found a key to opening it. Oh yes, I got it. It's off. It has a cork. There we go. Right away, I see a darker color than Bulleit bourbon usually has. Or Bulleit. Bulleit Distilling Company, Louisville, Kentucky. Return for refund. Made from pure Kentucky limestone filtered water in the Bulleit family tradition. There's a little, it says drink responsibly, recycle, and there's a little no car right there. No car. No driving. I'll have the last little piece of this one triangular kind of oat cake. Oh, I love these things. Thanks, Equivite. You turned me on to something new that I never heard of before. Now that we got our bourbon right here in the glass, let's give it a nose. Oh, beautiful. Classic. Classic. Sweetness. Sweetness. Cherry. Brown sugar. There's quite a bit of rye in this from what I can. I'm getting some of that bite from the rye. And the sweetness of the corn whiskey. 10 years in the wood. 10 years in virgin American oak. Giving it caramel, vanilla. Classic caramel, vanilla. Brown sugar, cherries. Cherry cola almost. If there was a swimming pool of this stuff, I would dive right in. Beautiful nose. I'm liking this a lot. Classic aged bourbon. It's bottled at, what did I say, 45.6%. So it's in that range, 45 to 50. I get deeper into it, and there's more caramel. More caramel. More vanilla. Oh, classic. This is your classic bourbon nose. It's not going to get any more authentic or any more this is the real deal. Oh. Going over 10 minutes already. I might as well taste it. It smells so good though. I could keep going for another 10 minutes before tasting it. Well, now that I've got the oat cakes absorbing all the flavors that were in my mouth before, let's wash it down with some water. And here we go. Interesting. I would have expected a thicker, oilier mouthfeel, but it's not that thick, and it's not that oily. What kind of legs does it have? They don't stick to the side of the glass too long. It just kind of rolls off the side. It rolls right down. Yeah. The legs are not very thick and they just kind of zoop right down in the glass. This is interesting. This is strange. This is like a watered down cough syrup almost. It's a style of bourbon that well, it has a rye bite, and it has cherries, cherry cola, la 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 la, la. Tastes just like cherry cola. I'm not getting much of that brown sugar. I'm not getting so much of that caramel on the palate as I did on the nose. Yeah, I just like cherry cola. A lot of cherry, some cola, not so much vanilla and caramel on this one. This one just is like maraschino cherries, but not so thick. The mouthfeel reminds me of the mouthfeel I got from Old Ezra, from the Ezra Brooks Distillery. I believe it was a 7-year-old Kentucky straight bourbon bottled at 50%. This is bottled at 45.6, but it still has that thin mouthfeel. The mouthfeel has no, it's not viscous at all. I'm surprised. I thought it would be much more viscous than this. This makes it dangerously, the legs just fall right down. They don't stick to the side of the glass too long. This is different. It's great, actually. It's just I would have expected a thicker mouthfeel, but maybe that's because I was drinking some Maker's 46 and some Elijah Craig 12 this morning, and that stuff is a lot thicker than this. Yeah, this is easy to drink. It's really good. And the price point. Ooh. Heavy cherry flavor. And strangely enough, it's not that much wood. You don't, you taste some wood, but it's more cherry than wood. Very interesting bourbon, this one. I paid $53.09, and with the GST and liquor tax, it was $61.04. Not bad for a 10-year-old bourbon. Aged bourbons often cost much more than that, but it's in the range for, you know, prices in Canada. I know you can probably get this for like $30 in the States, but in Canada and British Columbia, they got you tight. So you just have to make do with what the government allows you to have, I suppose. But this is not bad at all. For the price, it's a decent little bourbon. To your very good health and cheers.
Food quig.
Food quig.
Food quig.
Food quig.
Food quig.
Yeah.
Yeah.